ختامها مسك الاستاذ الدكتور طارق الزواوي، هيكلمنا على انترافينوس ايرن هارت فيلير، وزي ما هيشرح لنا الدكتور طارق الزواوي عايزين نفرق ما بين ايرن ديفيشنسي وانيميا. يعني ممكن قوي العيان يكون عنده هارت فيلير وايرن ديفيشنسي وذات انيميا. اوكي دكتور طارق الزواوي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طبعا انا بتوجه بالشكر للاستاذ الدكتور محمود حسنين لفيري ذيس اكسلنت ساينتفك بروجرام. ويمكن حضرتك في بدايه السيشن قلت نوفل دراجز فور مي هيلب هارت فيلير بيشنتس. انا قبل ما ابتدي بس عايز اقول يعني كلمه واحده على الجلاكتيك هارت فيلير ترايل. ذيس از جاست ببلشد ان ذا امريكان هارت اسوسيشن ان نوفمبر 2020 and the consensus said that it is a omecamtiv mecarbil is a promising drug and may help patients with heart failure and may be in the future the fifth group of the drugs for treatment of heart failure. This is just my comment. About the iron deficiency anemia or iron deficiency in heart failure, it is what is the current evidence and the practical recommendations. Iron deficiency is a frequent comorbidity in patients with stable chronic heart failure and in patients admitted to hospital with acute heart failure. And heart failure complicated with iron deficiency is associated with impaired functional capacity, poor quality of life, and increased mortality. The prevalence of iron deficiency in heart failure is variable in different trials. However, in the average or in this trial published in 2013, about 50% of patients with heart failure have iron deficiency. Those with anemia may reach up to 60% or more, and those with iron deficiency with non-anemic reach 45%. There are two types of iron deficiency. However, the functional or relative iron deficiency, in such case, the ferritin, which is the iron store, is normal, and the transferrin saturation is low due to defective iron mobilization from the reticuloendothelial system to bone marrow. In the absolute iron deficiency, there is decrease the serum ferritin and decrease the transferrin saturation, and in such case, there is worsening of the heart failure, decrease the iron absorption due to high hepcidin and increased bowel edema, or also other causes may contribute to the iron deficiency. This slide shows that the pathophysiology of iron deficiency in heart failure may be related to the inflammatory cytokines, the tumor necrosis factor and the interleukin 6, which are elevated in patients with heart failure. This leads to increased hepcidin. Hepcidin is a protein secreted by the liver in the presence of inflammation in CKD patients in chronic heart failure. And this hepcidin inhibits the absorption of iron from GIT, and at the same time decrease the iron release from the iron stores in the hepatocytes and the macrophages, and these contribute to iron deficiency anemia. Also, those patients with heart failure may receive anticoagulant, antiplatelet, and there may be a chronic blood loss which contribute to the iron deficiency. Iron deficiency anemia in heart, iron deficiency in heart failure has a dual mechanism of action. It may lead to decrease oxygen supply to the hemoglobin and decrease oxygen delivery, and at the same time may cause a decrease at the mitochondrial level, decrease in ATP synthesis. All this leads to decrease the functional capacity and decrease in BVO2 in such patients. Iron deficiency is an independent factor associated with the reduced exercise capacity, reduced quality of life, and the poor outcome in heart failure. And this study shows that the iron deficiency is associated with increased mortality, and those with iron deficiency with no anemia increased the mortality compared to heart failure patients without anemia, and those iron deficiency together with anemia higher mortality than those without anemia. Iron deficiency is considered an independent risk factor, or also independent of anemia, is considered predictive of NEHA class of the patient, decreased aerobic performance, poor exercise tolerance, lower quality of life, and increased risk of heart transplantation. These are independent of anemia, and the iron deficiency per se may correlate with the structural remodeling in patients with heart failure and correlated with the left ventricular dilatation and poor ejection fraction. At the same time, anemia is considered a predictor of mortality and is an independent risk of also in mortality based on the SHARM program. The presence of anemia increased the mortality. However, the patient with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction or preserved ejection fraction, also frequent hospital admission is increased in patients with anemia. For the treatment of iron deficiency, intravenous iron treatment using the ferric carboxy maltose. There is a lot of trial testing this drug for patients with iron deficiency anemia, trials that improve the symptoms and the quality of life, fair heart failure, confirm and effect heart failure trial. I will discuss in brief each trial. Trial as regards the morbidity and the mortality, affirm acute heart failure, fair heart failure 2, and the heart feed trial. Only affirm acute heart failure just presented in the American Heart Association in November 2020. The FAIR heart failure trial using ferric carboxy maltose in patients with heart failure and iron deficiency published in 2009. And this trial included patients with NEHA class 2 to 3 and ejection fraction less than 40, hemoglobin 9.5 to 13.5 gram, and the definition of iron deficiency anemia or iron deficiency according to the European Society of Cardiology, the serum ferritin less than 100 microgram per liter, or if it is between 100 and 300, the trans saturation, the trans ferritin saturation must be less than 20%. This is the definition of iron deficiency anemia. And those patients received ferric carboxy maltose IV injection, 200 milligram weekly, till correction of the iron store, and then IV iron every 4 weeks as a maintenance. And follow up to 26 weeks for safety evaluation, and up to 24 weeks for NEHA class and symptoms assessment. And the primary endpoints of this trial show that there is improvement of the patient global assessment at week 24, and the NEHA class significantly decreased at week 24. Also, the patient global assessment started the increase by the week 4 and more improvement by the week 24, and also the NEHA class more improvement by the week 24. The second endpoint about the functional capacity and 6-minute walk test significantly improved, and the conclusion of this trial that the intravenous iron therapy resulted in improvement of the symptoms and functional capacity, and it appears to be safe drug. The second trial, the confirmed heart failure trial, and the inclusion criteria of this trial the same as FAIR trial, those patients with heart failure and iron deficiency. In all trials and the guidelines that we must give يعني is a contraindication to give intravenous iron if the hemoglobin more than 15, as we'll see in the guidelines. For all the trials, the hemoglobin was less than 15 grams per deciliter. This trial was designed to assess the functional capacity of those patients, and we found there is a significant improvement of the functional capacity as assessed by 6-minute walking distance at 24 weeks. The first hospitalization due to worsening heart failure significantly decreased. The third trial is the effect trial. The effect trial also included the same inclusion criteria, patients with heart failure function class 2 to 3, ejection fraction less than 45, and with iron deficiency as the definition before, and they give intravenous iron carboxymaltose, ferric carboxymaltose, at day zero, and then after 6 weeks, and then after 12 weeks, and after 24 weeks. And the primary endpoint is change in the VO2 max from baseline to week 24, and there was significant improvement in the functional capacity. The NEHA class decreased by the week 24, and the self-reported patient global assessment improved. And the conclusion of this trial in symptomatic patients with heart failure and iron deficiency, treatment with IV ferric carboxymaltose over 24-week period resulted in significant beneficial effect on peak VO2 compared with the standard treatment, irrespective of the baseline of anemia. This is a real-world evidence using IV iron in patients with heart failure and iron deficiency. This is published in 2020. This real-world evidence included more than 2,000 patients with heart failure and reduced ejection fraction. Iron deficiency was present in 50%, 55% of those patients. Iron deficiency with anemia in 29%. And the conclusion of this trial that in the real-world cohort of patients with heart failure, treatment with IV iron was used in 1/3 of patients with iron deficiency and anemia, and appears safe in mid-term follow-up. And all-cause deaths in patients with iron deficiency, anemia, and heart failure significantly decreased compared to those without IV iron therapy, and also the cardiovascular deaths significantly decreased. And those with anemia and iron deficiency anemia, also the all-cause deaths and the cardiovascular deaths decreased significantly. Recently, this is a trial addressing the morbidity and the mortality. As I mentioned, just published in the American Heart Association November 2020, a firm acute heart failure trial using intravenous ferric carboxymaltose in hospitalized patients with acute heart failure. The study included 1,100 patients hospitalized with acute heart failure who had iron deficiency as defined as before the definition, serum ferritin less than 100, or if it is between 100 and 300, you have transferritin saturation less than 20. And in this trial, the patient received IV iron zero date, then after 2 weeks, and week 4, week 6, week 12, week 24, and then week 36, and week 52. The primary outcome, the recurrence of heart failure hospitalization and the cardiovascular death. The secondary outcome, composite recurrent cardiovascular hospitalization and the cardiovascular death, hospitalization of heart failure, the composite heart failure hospitalization or cardiovascular death, days lost due to heart failure hospitalization. The results showed that the total heart failure hospitalization and the cardiovascular death decreased significantly by 21%. And the primary and secondary outcome, the total heart failure hospitalization and the cardiovascular death decreased by 21%. Total heart failure hospitalization decreased by 24%. Cardiovascular death decreased by 4%. The first heart failure hospitalization or cardiovascular death decreased by 20%, and the total cardiovascular hospitalization and the cardiovascular death decreased by 20%. And they concluded that AFFIRM acute heart failure trial supported the recommendation to administer IV iron ferric carboxy maltose in patients hospitalized with acute heart failure with concomitant iron deficiency and those with ejection fraction less than 50%. This is the guidelines. The guidelines, the European guidelines for the treatment of heart failure 2016 recommend the screening and the laboratory test. We have to check hemoglobin and check ferritin and transferrin saturation and total iron binding capacity as a class one recommendation. In all patients we have with heart failure, we have to screen for iron deficiency. And the diagnosis, as mentioned before, the ferritin level less than 100, and if it is between 100 and 300, the transferrin saturation less than 20%. And the guidelines recommend IV ferric carboxy maltose should be considered in order to alleviate heart failure symptoms and improve exercise capacity and quality of life. This is class 2A. Level of evidence A. The American guidelines for treatment of heart failure 2017 also recommend IV iron replacement might be reasonable to improve functional capacity and quality of life. This is class 2B. My last slides about the practical guidance on the treatment of iron deficiency in patients with chronic heart failure based on the recommendation of European Society of Cardiology 2018, why screen for iron deficiency? Iron deficiency is a common in heart failure and is associated with reduced functional capacity, impaired quality of life, and worse prognosis, irrespective of anemia status. Clinical trials of IV iron therapy conducted in patients with symptomatic heart failure demonstrate that correction of iron deficiency is associated with significant improvement in exercise capacity, symptoms, health-related quality of life, and the possible reduction of recurrent hospitalization. In whom and when to give IV iron therapy? Iron therapy is indicated or should be considered in symptomatic patients with heart failure and ejection fraction less than 40 and with the iron deficiency as mentioned before, and this is class 2A recommendation. Which iron preparation and route? IV iron therapy with ferric carboxy maltose is recommended by the current guidelines, and however, oral iron therapy has not been shown to be an effective treatment option for iron deficiency in patients with congestive heart failure. And this is a suggested treatment algorithm, which dose to give and how to give. Based on the FAIR heart failure trial, we give the 200 milligram IV weekly till correction of iron deficiency, then given as a maintenance every 1 month, and we can recheck the ferritin and transferrin saturation after 1 to 3 months. And we have to check the level of ferritin and transferrin saturation in patients every 1 to 2 years in patients with heart failure. Otherwise, the clinical situation necessitates the assessment of the iron stores. Also, based on the confirmed heart failure trial, we can use the single dose ranging from 500 to 1,000 milligram IV, And we rechecked the ferritin level after 1 to 3 months and give the maintenance dose 500 milligram every 1 month. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Tari Zawawi, for this excellent presentation. And I have a question. Who is testing for iron deficiency in heart failure in the audience? Who is testing for iron deficiency in heart failure? يعني هي minority الحقيقة هما minority. طيب what treatment regimen إيه يعني بس الدكتور الزهو دلوقتي عندنا في مصر ما عندناش فيريك كاربوكسي مالتوز. It's not available in Egypt.
Unfortunately, اللي available.
What are you using now for treatment of iron deficiency؟ برضو عايز stress point في فرق ما بين iron deficiency and anemia. يعني ممكن عيان heart failure هيموجلوبين 12 جرام أو أكتر وستيل he is iron deficient. فلازم نفرق ما بين iron deficiency and anemia. How are you going to treat in the Egyptian market ما عندناش فيريك كاربوكسي مالتوز.
Unfortunately, the Egyptian market اللي موجود فيريك سكروز. وفيريك سكروز في small trials عليه. فعشان كده ما فيش وحصل improvement مع الفيريك سكروز للfunctional capacity. But ما فيش trials كبيرة عليه فعشان كده not mentioned in the guidelines. ولكن في سمول ترايلز على فيريك سكروز اللي هو موجود في الايجيبشن ماركت.
اظن فيريك سكرايد او حاجه زي كده.
فيريك سكروز فيريك سكروز ال ايرن الفيريك كاربوكسي مالتوز عليه ترايلز زي ما وضحنا هنا هو فعشان كده الجايد لاينز يعني ريكومند فيس تايب اوف ايرن. الاورال is not recommended.
ده نقطة مهمة. Oral iron is not
recommended.
It's not beneficial in patients with لأن الجات إديما تمنع الأبسوربشن ويتيكس يمكن
الأبسوربشن هيبقى قليل مش does not affect the hepcidin اللي هو released from the liver وهيقلل الأبسوربشن وهيقلل ال release of iron. فالترايل كان في ترايل اسمها iron out trial demonstrate that oral iron is not recommended.
Of no use. Of no use in patients with heart failure.
Thank you, Dr. for this great presentation and difficult topic, definitely. But all we know that in iron deficiency anemia is approximately 50% of heart failure patients. So I think it's a very good number. So yes, I think you need to search for the iron deficiency. Yes, this is number one. But the problem is the level of iron. This is very important. The level of iron is higher is better for the heart but bad for the brain. So it increases the risk of a stroke. So you need to be cautious with the level of the iron. This is very important.
أنا عايز أقول معيش حاجة اسمح دكتور عمرو حديدي. In our Egyptian registry, our prevalence of anemia كانت في الميلز about 52%, في الفيميلز 83%. فتصور in our Egyptian patients with heart failure, anemia in males 52%, in females 83%. فده موضوع quite vital in our Egyptian patients with heart failure.
أنا في حاجة برضو عايز أقولها بالنسبة لاختيار نوع الأيرن إن هما الفيريك كاربوكسي مالتوز قالوا إن ده ديكستران فري فبالتالي not immunogenic مش هيعمل allergy
أو يعملش anaphylaxis
وفي نفس الوقت ما بيحصلش منه release of an ionic iron اللي هو ممكن يعمل اوكسيديتيف ستريس فعشان كده هم اختاروا
ويا ريت نقدر يبقى كل افيلبل في مصر يعني
دكتور طارق ثانك يو فور ذس فيري امبورتنت اي ثينك اليجنت برزنتيشن اي ثينك وي مس ان ذا مانجمنت اوف اكيوت هارت فيلير بيشنتس هير ان اور هوسبيتالز اي ثينك تو سيرش فور فيريتين اند تو دايجنوز دو يو ثينك ذات that this will be one major cause for the intractability for heart failure, do you think? Because we have a lot of patients stay a long time in the hospital with that with this sluggish improvement.
Yes.
Do you think that's
yes.
So we have to do. Yes. So I think we have.
Yeah, and if the guidelines, the class 2A.
Class 2A, it should be considered.
Well, class 2A.
بينفت مع انترافينوس ايرن اكتر من اللي شفناه مع الفيريسيكوات او مع الاوميكا
yes. يعني evidence is higher.
A simple treatment which improves the functional capacity for your hospital. سؤال اتفضل.
انا برضه عايز انوه على الاريثروبيوتين is class 3 recommendation. يعني contraindicated الإريثروبيوتين to correct anemia in heart failure.
برغم إخواننا النفرولوجيست بيستعملوه كتير قوي.
هم قالوا إن في CKD it is recommended. But we have to monitor the ferritin عشان برضو الايرن ما يبقاش زايد ادي ولكن in heart failure class 3 recommendation.
حضرتك بتقول انه يفضل ما يكونش اورال ايفن لو الدودينال اللي هو الايرن اللي ما بيتفتحش الكبسوله الا في الدودينال اللي هو الدودينال ولا حضرتك تقصد الاذر رود ذان ذا الجات
يعني تقصد مش فاهم
حضرتك
الاورال بتكلم على الاورال
اورال في نوعين في واحد بيفتح في الاستومك واحد بيفتح في الدودينال
لا 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 ما هو مش
حضرتك تقصد كله
في ترايل اتعملت بالاورال اير
ما انا بتكلم على كده
ترايل اسمها ايرن اوت
عملوا ترايل بالاورال
بالاورال وفيل
لان هي ماتر اوف ابزوربابيلتي كله بيبقى فيه جات كونجيشن فبيبقى فيه فيلر اوف ابزوربشن
بالظبط الجات دي ما بتمنع الابزوربشن الاير اي اسئله اخرى طب انا بشكر طارق ينفع
طبعا انا اكسلنت برزنتيشن حاجه اوتستاندينج مع احترامي للخواجات يعني ما اعتقدش ان انت الخواجه كان هيعمل احسن منك يعني. لكن إن في كام سلايد عندك لازم تطبعهم تخلي نوباس تشتغل معاك عشان تلف على الناس اللي هو التشيك بتاع الايرون والفريتين ده مش الفريتين ده طلع ايام الكوفيد بس ولا حد كان يسمع عنه ولا حد يسمع عنه انا عمري ما شفته مع ناس كتير قوي انما توتال ايرون بالانس كاباسيتي يس الحاجات اللي انت كتبته ده مهم هي المشكله في المشكله تريتمنت طب وبعدين بعد ما تعمله هتعالجه ازاي؟ ما انت هتعالجه الافيلابل عندك العلاج ولا مش افيلابل عندك العلاج؟ يبقى لازم
شركات الادويه بتوعنا الفارماسيوتيكال كومباني اللي عندنا ان هم يوفروا لنا ده
يعني يعملوا شركه ايه اسمها؟
هو
شركه ايه يا طارق؟
هو مش في الفيروسات
الفيروساك
لا الفيروساك لا لا الفيروساك ده فيروس فيركس سكريز ده مش هو هو ده اسمه انجكت فير
طب لو انت عندك سي كي دي زي ما كان حد بيتكلم عليه سي كي دي مثلا عندك كرياتين 3.5 4 وعندك هيموجلوبين بتاعك زي مثلا 9 زي ما بيعملوا بتوع الكلى وعندك هارت فيلير بتاعك قول اي جي اف ار باطي وبتقعد كده من غير انت بقى ما تعمل قصتك دي بتقعد كده بيدو اتروبيتين فهل هو انت هو لازم مع ده تعمل الثانيه تعمل فريتين توتال امبر كاباسيتي عشان تفرق ده ايرن ديفيشنسي مش انيميا
السي كي دي بيشنس قال لك اب تو 40% اوف سي كي دي بيشنس عندهم ايرن ديفيشنسي انيميا توجذر ويز بون مارو ديفكتيف هيماتوبيسيس فال الإريثروبايتين مشكلته ان هو بيعمل ثرومبوسايتوسيس فبيزود الثرومبو امبوليك مانيفيستاشنز وبيعمل اندوثيليال ديسفانكشن باكتيفيت الرينال انجيوتنسي سيستم والاندوثيلين والديكريز النيتروكسايد له مشاكل كثيره جدا فهم قالوا ريكومندد في سي كي دي بس وي هاف تو جيف سمولر دوز تو مينتين الهيموجلوبين ان سي كي دي بيشنتس بتوين 10 تو 12 and to monitor the serum ferritin and transferritin saturation.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Tariq. We come to the end of our first day of advanced course in heart failure.